Let's find out center of mass of a solid sphere. So as we know, solid sphere will be collection of a disk. So at a distance y from the center of a solid sphere, I select one disk. This is our disk, and this distance I am taking y. So thickness of this disk, this thickness, that will be dy. Now this is formula for center of mass, for continuous distribution of mass, y dm divided by integration d. Now I have to find out dm and y and put in this formula, integrate, and I'll get center of mass. Now how to find out dm? Dm is mass of this disk. What disk I selected? So mass of that disk, if I make this separate diagram for this disk, thickness of this disk dy and radius of this disk r. Here also we can write radius of this disk r. So mass of this disk dm is equal to total mass of a complete solid sphere divided by volume of complete solid sphere into volume of a disk by r square into dy. See, this is volume density, mass divided by total volume, volume density. Volume density multiplied by volume of a disk is equal to mass of a disk. And this is volume of a disk, because area of disk pi r square and height of that disk dy. So this will be volume of a disk, and this is what, volume density. Volume density multiplied by volume is equal to mass of this disk. Now I got dm. So in place of this dm, I put this value. So when I put this value in place of dm, I'll get ycm is equal to three m by 2 pi r cube into pi r square dy, and this y also there. Because of this y, I am writing over here. Divide by 3m divided by 2 pi r cube into pi r square dy. What I did, in this formula, in place of this dm, I wrote this value. In place of this dm also, I wrote this value. Now whatever thing will be constant, that get cancelled. So if you see in this one, this get cancelled, even this pi get cancelled. Now I can write ycm is equal to r square y dy divided by r square dy. Now in place of y, what I can write, if you look at this disk, this distance, this one is capital R, this distance y. So if I make separate diagram of that one, so this distance will be capital R, this distance is small r, that's the radius of a disk, and this distance y. So using Pythagoras theorem, we can write over here, r square is equal to capital R square minus y square. So in place of this r square, I put this value. So ycm is equal to capital R square minus y square into y dy divided by R square minus y square dy. If I integrate this one, I'll get R square y square by 4, R square y square by 2, not 4. See, I multiply y over here, integration of y square by 2 and R square as it is. So if I multiply over here, I'll get y cube, and integration of y cube, I'll get y power 4 divided by 4. See, if I integrate this one, R square y, see y will be multiplied over here, so R square constant, so integration of y square by 2, but if I multiply y over here, that will be y cube, and integration of y cube, y power 4 by 4. And similarly we can write over here, this is R square y minus y cube by 3. Now what will be limit of this integration? See, what's a variable over here? If you look at this diagram, what's a variable over here? Y. So what's the minimum value of y? 0. And what's the maximum value of y? Capital R. So I'll put limit from 0 to capital R. So limit will be 0 to capital R, and here also 0 to capital R. So same limit we can put over here, 0 to capital R, and here 0 to capital R. Now if I calculate in place of y, I'll write upper limit with minus sign lower limit. So if I put upper limit, I'll get r power 4 divided by 2 minus r power 4 divided by 4, and here I'll get r cube minus r cube by 3. So if I solve this one, I'll get r power 4 divided by 4, and this one 2r cube by 3. This r power 4 and r cube get cancelled. This one if I calculate, I'll get 3r divided by 3. If you see this solid sphere, this one, it's a symmetrical about x axis. So xcm will be 0 only. And what will be ycm? Ycm will be this 3r by 8. So xcm of solid sphere, it's a 0, and ycm of a solid sphere, that will be 3r by 8. So this is center of mass of a solid sphere.